Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to give you my list of 11 design resources for graphic designers. Now, a few of these are paid sites, but most of them are free. But then some of the free ones do have restrictions on how you can use the file. So I'll let you know which ones have restrictions as we go. I'm also going to put these in categories, and you'll see on the video itself, on the timeline, there should be little categories you can click on to see the ones you're interested in. All right, let's get started. Photos to use in your projects. This first site is pexels.com, and on this site the photos and videos are free for personal and commercial use. And there's no attribution necessary, meaning you don't have to credit the author, but they do appreciate that, of course. Now, these photos are great if you have a kind of generic blog and you want to put generic photos on your blog. But if you're looking for a specific image, it's not so great. So let's search for landscape. There is some really amazing landscape photography. And these are sort of, you know, generic images. If you want to get more specific, like I used to work for a healthcare agency, so a lot of times we would need very specific healthcare images. So something like doctor with iPad. And really, there's nothing here that I could use. I'd have to go to Shutterstock or another one of the paid stock websites to get that type of imagery. She's not actually a doctor, for example. She's a pregnant woman going in for a sonogram. So there's really nothing I could use in that case. This next site is also for photos, unsplash.com. And it's just like Pexels. You don't have to do an attribution. You can use them for personal and commercial projects. So it's very similar. We can also type landscape here to see what kind of images we get. Wow, a lot of really great ones. Well, let's try doctor with an iPad again here. We have some doctors on an iPad, and we have a doctor, but no iPad. So if you need more specific images, you'll have to go with a paid site, most likely. Vector images. For vector images, pixabay.com is really great, and it has a similar license as Pexels and Unsplash, meaning you can use these for personal and commercial use, and you don't have to do an attribution. And they have some really great ones on here. Icons and icon sets. The Noun Project is a really great website for icons. Now, there's a difference here. If you use these icons, you do have to add an attribution for the creator. But let's type in healthcare. Okay, and there are a lot of really great healthcare icons out here. A lot of different styles, and these are all very usable in my opinion. Let's try food icons. You'll notice that all the icons on this site are black. And of course they're vectors, so they can be recolored however you like. Learning new graphic design skills. If you want to learn a new program or learn about design theory or something like that, and you want to watch full courses, Skillshare is really great. Skillshare really focuses on creative courses. Other sites like Udemy usually offer every type of course you can think of, but Skillshare really focuses on creative ones. Now, this site is really cool because you don't pay for individual classes. You just pay a monthly subscription and you get access to all the classes on the entire website. And by the way, if you want to try this out, I have a link in a comment below the video where you can get 2 free weeks to test it out. And after that, I think it's something like $10 a month. I've been a subscriber here myself for a few years, and it's really nice to learn something new. Right now, I've been really focusing on After Effects. Another great resource, which you've apparently already found, is YouTube. Now, with YouTube, you're going to get mostly really small videos on how to do one specific thing. So if we go out here and search for graphic design, you can see how long these videos are. This one's about 9 minutes, 6 minutes. This one's 12 minutes, so they're really short. They're not full courses for the most part. But if you're wanting to learn, you know, how to make a wavy line around a circle or something like that, YouTube is the best place for that, in my opinion. Mockups. Placeit.net has a lot of both free and premium mockups. Now, the free ones can be used for commercial projects, so that is really cool. You can also use their videos to showcase a product, and there are free ones there too. So if we come over here to mockups and go to freebies, these are all the ones that you can use commercially that don't cost anything. And this site is also really easy to use. So you just click on the one you want to use, Then click Insert Image and you can upload from your device. And then it will allow you to kind of position it where you want. And then you just go to free download. Now, I think you'll have to have an account to actually download, but that's free too. Free fonts. You may already know about Google Fonts, but all these fonts that are offered on Google Fonts are free for personal and commercial use. You can also Google font pairing or Google font pairing, and those show you two fonts that work really well together. Then you can just come back here to this site and type in the name of the font. Then you can click on it and download the family, install it on your machine, and it's totally free. Also, Google Fonts is always expanding. They're always adding new ones. It's an awesome place to find really high-end, great fonts. Creating fonts. Now this site, FontSelf, isn't free, but in my opinion, it's totally worth it. It'll probably run you about $50, but you can make your own fonts inside Illustrator with this tool. I've sold a few of the fonts I made with FontSelf. I've made my money back many times over. I also have an affiliate link with FontSelf, and that's in the description below, and that will save you 10%. And I also get a little something, I think $5 or something like that, for each referral that I make. If you want to see a video about how FontSelf works, you should be able to see that link on your screen. Web design inspiration. Anytime I have to make a new website, I come out here to Theme Forest. So let's say I'm making a healthcare website. I can just type that into the search. And then there are a bunch of templates, and these are actually templates that you can buy and use, but I usually just look at these for ideas. So I'll open a few of these, and then you can do this live preview. So I use these sites as inspiration, like, oh, that's a neat way to do a slider, or, oh, I like this button. If you have to have three columns, how you can make that work and look nice, or have icon sections like this. So it just gives you ideas on how to lay out your web page. Like, oh, maybe I could do something like this. And of course, with any inspiration that you take as a graphic designer, you should always be able to hold yours up and compare it to someone else's, and no one would be able to tell that you took the inspiration from them. Logo inspiration. For logo inspiration, I like Logospire. You can just scroll through lots of different ideas. It's just a gallery of logos. And it's kind of like Pinterest, it never ends. Now the only thing about this one is you can't search on this page, so you have to just scroll through and see if there's a style you like. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you!